Employees across the country are up in arms right now over proposed changes to their benefit packages. A stalemate in Wisconsin, we've been watching that unfold, was created when Democratic state senators left the state to prevent a vote that would have eliminated collective bargaining. Mike Vasalinda reports tonight from our exclusive Capitol Bureau. Relations here in Florida are starting to simmer as well.
Governor Rick Scott wants state employees to start paying 5% of their salaries toward pensions, and he wants them to get only limited payments for health insurance.
If you're a taxpayer in the state, you know, you most likely don't have a pension plan. If you even have a 401k plan, your employer might not contribute.
30 Palm Beach County firemen were in Tallahassee getting the lay of the land.
Every worker should be concerned about the pension.
Others have been giving the governor an earful.
Now, some of the proposals that are out there could get people pretty riled up, particularly on retirement and on health benefits.
But Florida is not likely to be Wisconsin. Just before the turn of the 20th century, these Florida lawmakers, like those in Wisconsin, went across the state line to keep the Senate from having a quorum. But that couldn't happen today. The reason? Republicans are in such total control, they don't need a single Democrat vote to do anything they want, as long as they all stick together. Senator John Thrasher has upped the anger level by introducing legislation to keep the state from payroll deducting union dues.
Government should not be using their resources to collect union dues. Simple as that.
Florida Education Association President Andy Ford says Thrasher's bill is nothing more than payback.
In our mind, once the election's over, it's over, and you need to work together and try to bring everybody back together.
While other states are at the boiling point, Florida's public employees are just starting to plan demonstrations. In Tallahassee, Mike Vasalinda, WPTV News Channel 5.